Hello my friends, today I am here with a very important topic in research methodology workshop series. This topic is relevant and very important for all researchers and also PhD and master students who are just entering into their research area. So first thing they should understand is how we can formulate a very good research topic and then refining it. So this would be my today's topic, how we can formulate any research topic and refine that. I am Dr. Muhammad Imran Qureshi, working in University Technical Malaysia, Melaka. I'm also founding director of Connecting Asia and also president of the APRA, the Association of Researcher and Academicians Pakistan chapter. And at the same time, I am reviewer and editor of quite a few journals. I am editor of Journal of Management Info and Journal of Technology Management and Technopreneurship, and also the Journal of Systematic Literature Review and Meta-Analysis. So this is my brief introduction. So let's go to the topic. Now, first thing we should understand, this is very important for all those researchers who are entering new into the research area. They should consider how or what are the steps through which they can formulate a very relevant and very important research topic, and then how we can refine that particular research topic in order to get maximum or more relevant research area where we can give our maximum input. So this is today's topic. There would be three learning outcomes for this lecture. The first one, we should understand how we can gather or identify the attributes of any good research topic. So what are the major attributes where we consider that this topic is very important and relevant? The second one is how we can gather different ideas and use them to formulate a very good research topic. And finally, how we can convert these ideas into research questions and research objective. So this would be very simple, straight three outcomes for today's lecture. So let us start with how we can do with the research attributes. What are the major attributes or characteristics of any research topic we can consider it a very good research area to be studied? The three major components on which we decide whether this area is considerably good or not. The first thing is your capabilities. The second thing is your appropriateness. And the third thing is your relevance. So these are the three major components through which you can understand any topic is important for you or for research or not. The first thing is your capabilities. Do I have enough time? Do I have enough capabilities to handle this research project or research topic? Do I have enough resources? Do I have enough data analysis techniques which I need to learn? Or other related factors related to resources, related to time, related to personal capabilities and surroundings and ethics also. So all these are your capabilities. So whether you are capable enough to take this research area, that is good for you or not. The second one is appropriate. Whether this is worthwhile to do this. This area is new, or you have enough already published literature on this. If this is the case, you should not do that article or you should not consider that topic, because you already have enough information to formulate a solution for any particular issue or challenge. So what we do in research topics, we try to bring something new, novel, something which contributes to the body of knowledge. So that's why we should consider that whether this area where I'm going to study or where I'm going to do my research topic, whether this area is good enough. The idea I'm thinking is relatively new. Is it worthwhile to use this idea for my research topic? So these are the major components you should understand whether my research topic is appropriate or not. So this is the second point. Okay, the first point is basically your capability. The second point is appropriateness. And the third point is relevance. Whether this topic is relevant or not, whether it is relevant to my area of interest or not, my studies, my specific research or degree requirements, or requirements set by the organization where I am working. So this is also need to be considered, whether this topic is relevant or not. So in nutshell, what I can tell you is these three major attributes you should consider while you are thinking about any topic. Okay, so you should ask yourself these questions: whether I am capable to take this topic, it means that do I have enough time, enough resources, enough skills, and other requirements set for the particular topic. Okay, so this is the first thing. The second one is appropriateness, whether this topic is new, is it worthy to consider this specific topic, or I can deliver something new or relatively productive in my research. And finally, whether it is relevant with my area of interest, with my targets, with my objectives of the degree, or maybe objectives of my publication, or if it is applied research, whether it is directly relevant to the solution of any problem which is I am going to use in my research. So if you are planning to solve any problem for any organization, you should consider whether your topic and your area is directly related to that particular problem or not. So this is the complete three sets attributes of any research topic, whether this topic is good enough or not. Even when you are publishing in any good research journal, these three things should be considered by the editors: whether this topic is good enough, it is new, and it is relevant to the latest findings or latest area of research. So if these things are valid, then you can consider this topic is good enough for you to carry on. Okay, so when you consider any topic, ask yourself these questions, and in the light of these answers, you can consider your area or whether you should refine it or not. Okay, so this is the attributes. So three attributes are very clear. Okay, now let's move to the next point, whether we should consider how we can generate new ideas. What are the methods of new idea generation? The second point or second outcome of today's lecture. So means that we should understand what are the major techniques through which you can generate different ideas, and later we can consider these ideas as your topic and choose these different ideas you generated through these techniques, and then you can consider them in your research. So you can generate maybe multiple options and then you just finalize one. So how you can do that? There are two major techniques of this. These techniques, the first one is your rational thinking. So you explore yourself, you explore your available resources, okay, and try to relate it with the literature. So how you can explore? Whether you can use this rational thinking or you can use creative thinking. Rational thinking is more like assisted method of finding out, or scientific method of finding out any research topic. On the other hand, the creative thinking is your own creativity. The more creative you are, the more ideas you should have. Okay, I can explain each of these in detail in this slide. Okay, now let's consider this. Creative thinking, you should create a list of ideas, a notebook of ideas, whenever it comes to your mind. It is not one-time process. It is not you will sit and you will get a very good creative idea. No, it is not going to happen. What you need to do is you need to sit down whenever you have any creative idea, just create a list of those ideas, and then you can brainstorm those ideas in later stage. So first thing, you should create the list or notebook of ideas in the creative thinking. But on the other hand, for the rational thinking, what we do, we use our personal data, we use our self-interest. What is my interest? So that is what I told you in the last class. So use your self-interest and try to figure out which area you are interested in. Try to figure out your interest in different fields, so then whatever you like more, you can consider that as your starting of your research topic. So means that you should consider your own interest more than creating different set of ideas, okay, in the rational thinking. Then in the creative thinking, you should consider the personal preferences. Personal preferences are very important, whether you have capabilities, whether I have interest in that particular topic, on whatever these set of ideas you generated in the past, you can use your personal preferences mechanism to identify which are more appropriate for you. But on the rational thinking, you can use past data, previously published articles, previously published research paper, previously published books, or previously published projects which you have already carried out. So you can use that information in order to refine your area or your topic. But in the creative thinking, you use personal preferences rather than the past data, okay? And then in the creative thinking, you create a relevant tree. Relevance tree is like the preferences and whether they are relevant to this area of interest, and your area of interest is relevant to the research objective you are going to set. Means that if you are interested in finding out what are the reasons for declines of sales in any company, so whatever you are going to do should be relevant to this research area. So that's why you should consider the relevance tree, and you can prepare these techniques. If you want to learn more about this relevant tree, you can figure out on the Google then, or I will prepare a future video for this also. In rational thinking, you search the previous published literature more, okay, rather than just focusing on your own previously done projects. You can search literature at the same time. That is for rational thinking, because it is very much rational, where you can consider identifying different types of the available solution to any specific problem that you can use through literature. You can search and figure out. In the creative thinking, you do brainstorming, more and more brainstorming, while in the rational thinking, you do more media search, newspapers, research articles, books, and all this. So these are the major major differences between these two methods, whether you go for with the creative thinking or you go with the rational thinking. So this is how you can generate different ideas. Means that in the rational thinking, you use your personal interests, you use your past data, you use literature, and you use search through the media or other platform in order to find whether the already available literature on some particular problem or already available information on specific topic. On the creative thinking, you try to explore your mind rather than the media and all this information. So what you do your own creative thinking. You create different ideas, then you personalize them, then you create relevance tree, whether these areas are relevant to the area of interest or the objective of my research, and then finally you brainstorm and finalize your area of interest or research topic. So here I would ask you, what is your research topic? Now consider your research topic. Here I'm giving you this example. My research topic, for an example, in this lecture would be digital marketing and sales, a company sales. So I'm interested to see whether these things are related or not, whether digital marketing will influence the sales or not. So these are my very basic research idea. So you should consider this after using this rational or creative thinking. What is your area of research? What is your topic? Okay. So once you identify your area of research would lead you to finding out the research topic. Okay. And when you finalize any research topic, then again go to the first step where you have these three steps where you can identify whether this topic is fair enough, the attributes are there or not, is it good or not, okay? So this is how you try to formulate your research idea. Now the second one, how you can refine. Now the final objective of this is to refine your idea and link these ideas with your research question and research objective. Now how you can use that? The most appropriate tool we use is Delphi method. A Delphi technique is very simple, where you use experts' opinion in order to refine your area. For example, if you have studied this, for example, I'm taking this example of digital marketing and sales, I would request any specific expert on the particular subject, for example digital marketing, and we ask them whether what I am going to do is considerably good topic or not, and based on their opinion and reply I would refine my research. So this is the first method. I hope so everybody know what is Delphi technique, but you must need to use it before finalizing the research topic, okay? Now you can also do a pilot test, a short study or briefing with your stakeholders, with interview with your stakeholder respondents or all those people who are maybe your participants of your research. So you can do a preliminary studies, which will, the reason of this study would be to evaluate whether your topic is relatively good or not. Okay, so you can use this information by using your preliminary study or pilot survey. Okay, then you have to test your ideas again and again with different people, with different your teacher, supervisor, your organization manager, so whoever is your stakeholder. So just discuss your idea and try to rectify and test your ideas again and again before finalizing your research objective. Now at the same time you have to integrate different ideas. For example, in the Delphi method you got another idea from a research expert in digital marketing. So he says, no, digital marketing on sales, it is already studied a lot. Why not you go with the digital marketing and sustainable development of the company or sustainable performance, or you go with any other topic. So that would be another idea which is coming from my other techniques. For example, Delphi method, the experts, they give me this idea. So I can use that idea in order to refine my topic. So I can just integrate different ideas. Finally, on the basis of all these, you have to refine your research work. You have to refine your research topic. So check different ideas, discuss with your friend, take experts' opinion, your supervisor, your other fellows. All these are basically can help you in refining your research. Now when we finalize any research topic, the next step would be to generate research questions and research objectives. I already explained to you how you can develop any research topic which is relevant, okay, which is new, and you are capable of doing that. Okay, you can refine those topics based on different ideas, but you should consider the different ideas you can generate through either rational thinking or creative thinking. In both cases you will find different ideas and then refine them to the one topic. So here our second objective is completed, where you need to understand how you can develop a good research topic. So once you are done with your research topic or research idea, the next step would be how we can translate that research topic into research questions. And this is where most of the researchers, they do mistakes. You should understand, writing research questions need a consistent and appropriate outcomes, okay? Because whenever you do any research, you highlight any research topic, it means that you have decided the research outcome. So your research question directly need to reflect your research objective or expected outcome. So consistent with the standards, able to produce clear conclusions. So this is your abilities of your research question. And it should be at right level, not too difficult, we cannot achieve or we cannot do it. And it should not be too much descriptive. Okay, how we can do that? Bringing your research idea to the right level is very important. In order to refine your research question, you should refine your topic very clearly. And for this reason, you can use this Goldilocks test. This test is being used widely among the researchers to identify what level of research and what level of topic you are doing, whether it is too much difficult, too much easy, or it is just a right level of your research topic or research question. So for this reason, let me explain to you what is this Goldilocks test. I'm going to ask you few questions, or you should ask these questions to yourself. Whether the answer is yes, it means that your topic is too easy. For example, the first question is, have you read it a lot of the time before? So many times you read this topic. When you are reading any particular topic, you are trying to study the relevant material, whether it is already available. And when you read any relevant research article, research book, or any newspaper or anything, you have a lot of information about it. Okay, so you understand this story very well. There is no ambiguity, there is no difficulties in understanding that particular topic. And the third one, do you know almost every word? So when you are reading that particular article which is relevant to your area of interest, every time you read, you can use and you can understand each and every word. Okay, if you do that, your answer is yes, you move to next question. Can you read it smoothly? You don't have any difficulty in reading. You don't have to think what I am reading, because are you reading without thinking? Because you already have enough information on that particular topic, so you don't need to understand or you don't need to think about that particular topic. If all these answers are yes, it means that your topic is too easy. So you should not consider that topic, okay? Now next is, you can use this test to identify whether your topic is too hard or not. So first thing, are there more than 5 words on a page you don't know? If you are reading something related to your area of interest and you are reading that, and more than 5 words in one page and you don't know the meaning and you don't understand those concepts, if yes, then move to the next point, because it is too much difficult for you. Are you confused? What is happening most of the time while reading? So you don't have clear story of that particular topic while you are reading. It means that this is too much difficult for you, okay? And then when you read, it does sound it's difficult to understand. You cannot understand the whole story. It means that you cannot interpret all the information. And finally, are you finding that you are not enjoying? If you are doing that, it means that all answers are yes. It means that this topic is too hard for you and you don't have the capabilities to go through this topic. So don't consider this one, okay? Now the third thing, where your best fit is, where you should consider your topic is very good for your research purpose, okay? Now first thing, just write, is topic new to you? Is it something or some element of newness in this topic which attracts you more? Okay, so if it is yes, then move to next point. Do you understand most of the ideas? So means that the story, the ideas, the concept involved in this research and relevant research topic, you can understand them very clearly, okay? Are the just couple of words on each page you don't know? It should not be like this. You should understand everything. If something is new, there must be some concept or relevant concept whether you are confused. So if these concepts are one or two on each page, it means that this topic have some element of newness in it, and it is not too much difficult also, okay? And when you read, some places write and some places copy. Some places you are facing difficulties and some places very easy. Some places you cannot interpret them correctly, and on most of the places you can interpret them, and the information available is understandable to you. If this is the case, yes, this topic is right for you. And finally, do you think as you read, your thought process, whether it has been provoked while you are reading this specific topic, while you are reading information about that specific topic? If yes, it means that this is the right topic for you. Okay, so this is Goldilocks test, whether you can identify whether your area of interest or research area is too hard, too difficult, or it is just right for you. Okay, so whenever you consider about any research article, you should consider on these points. So if these points yes, it means that this area of interest is research topic is good for you. Okay, now this is how we can consider our research topic as just right fit for us with our capability. Now when we highlight, we identify this, our research topic is right for us, it is have some element of newness, there are some concepts which need more investigation, and you have interest in that particular topic, so it means that your area or your topic is right enough, and then you can convert that topic into your research question. Now we have two different types of the research question. This is very important consideration. While you are considering your research, you should consider you have two different types of research questions. I label them two. There are so many other details are available, but I will tell you these details in future lectures. But here, just categorize them into two. First type of the research question is talking about what? Asking for opinion and gathering facts, investigating facts. What questions? It is also called descriptive research. And then there are so many other types of descriptive research which we can discuss later on. But here I'm just talking about when you are dealing with the research question, you should consider what, okay, what type of question. These types of questions related to descriptive nature of research. Okay, so for example, what is the relationship between digital marketing and sales? Now this is what, when we say what, it means that we will consider to finding out some empirical or other evidences to prove this claim or to explain this question what. Okay, so this is the first type of research question. The second type of research questions are not descriptive, using the question to go beyond description and require different or in detail analysis, that is called why questions. So why it is happening, why digital marketing is influencing on sales. Now you can clearly understand the difference between what and why questions. When you say what, you collect evidences. These evidences can be collected based on the research questionnaire or secondary data or all other data that we will explain later on in our next series of lectures. But here you should understand, while you are doing research, you should consider whether your research is what or why. Just simple for the beginners. If what, it means that you are going for evidences, and why, you are going for more detailed explanations. Okay, so why means why this is happening, why today weather is very hot. So this is difference. In first case, if you ask, okay, is today hot, it means that you are just asking yes or no, just asking investigating descriptive question. But when I ask why today is very hot here in this room, there may be multiple reasons, whether your sun outside, my AC is not working, electricity or fans are not working, or maybe there are some suffocations. So there are several reasons which need to be investigated later on. So here I am not interested in investigation of the fact of what. I am interested in what are the reasons why. So why gives you more detailed description. So first, research questions are more related to the quantitative side, and the second type of research questions are more related to the qualitative side, where you do interviews and collect other information. Okay, so you should consider your research questions falls in which area, why or what research question. Now when you write these research questions to research objectives, objectives are the outcomes of your research. Research questions are the investigations. It provides you the logic of your research design. But objectives are something which you want to achieve through your research. The goals, the objectives, okay? Now, objective, when you are writing about the objectives, you should consider these two very important factors or very important point. Check your examining body's preferences for stated objective. Whether you are doing this research for the organization, then you should consider their preferences. You should consider, and when you finalize this research objective, you should consider asking them about their research objective, whether these research objectives are fair enough and it served the purpose. And second, use a general focus question to achieve precise objectives. What does it mean? You have to clarify your objective in a very general manner and in order to collect a very specific information. How we do this? Let me show you a method at the end of this lecture. Okay, now, why and how we can do this? What technique is available to identify the right objective and right research pattern or design? So this is called a SMART approach. Very easy, everybody knows that. So your objective should be very specific. It should be measurable, whether it is achieved or not. It should be achievable. It should be realistic, and it should be time dependent. So when you set your objective, you should consider SMART approach. Whether my objective is achievable, whether it is specific, directly targeting to my outcome, whether it is achievable or not, and whether it is achievable within that time which I set for this research purpose, and is it realistic or not. Okay, so all these five steps you should consider while you're writing about your research objective. Okay, now I told you I will give you some example at the end. So this is my example. Now, first thing, my research idea is digital marketing, as I mentioned earlier. So what would be my research question? What is the impact of digital marketing on sales? This is first type of research question. If I go with the second type, how and or why digital marketing help in enhancing sales? How and why? So means that this you need more investigation, more detailed answers. Okay, so how, why, this type of question where you have more explanatory answers in your research. Okay, so these two types of the research question, same research, same objectives, sorry, same research, same relationship, sales and digital marketing, but the two different research question. Now how I convert these research questions to research objectives? So research questions, when you identify research question, research objective writing is very simple. For example, what is the impact of digital marketing on sales? Now my research objective would be to test the relationship between digital marketing or sales, or to test the impact of digital marketing on sales. On the other side, how digital marketing helps in enhancing sales? In that case, I am going to evaluate the effectiveness of digital marketing in enhancing organization sales. So these are very clear and precise research question and research objective, where I divided them into two, qualitative or quantitative, why or what. So you should consider writing your own a research question and research objective. I hope so. With this lecture, you are very clear about how you can write your research objectives and how you can refine your research topic. So, from your research topic up till the research objective, this was today's lecture outcome. And I hope so, after this lecture, you should be able to identify your research questions or research objectives very clearly. So, I would request you to write your research questions or research objective in the comment box below. Okay? Now, you can search literature, you can use rational thinking, or you can use creative thinking. Both options are very much okay with me. You can use both of them. But in this case, when you are using why question, you should consider writing objective in why type or quantitative method. Qualitative method. And when you are dealing with the what type of question, at that time you should consider writing your research objective in the quantitative manner. So this is very simple. If you follow these steps, you should be able to understand how you can formulate your research topic, how you can refine that, and finally how you can write your research question and objective. But remember, when you refine your research topic, use Goldilocks test to understand or to identify whether this is perfect fit for you or not. Okay, so you should read one page and answer those questions which I mentioned on that test. Okay, so let me conclude today's lecture in 2 minutes. We mainly focus on three outcomes for today's lecture. The first one, we discuss about the different attributes of research topic, whether this research topic is good or not. Then second one, we discuss how we can generate different ideas, where I discuss about the rational thinking and creative thinking, so you can create different ideas and then refine with Delphi method, with doing pilot survey, initial or basic studies, and then you discuss identify different idea, then gather them in one set of a refined idea. Okay, and then how we can convert those research ideas into, or research topic into, research questions and research objective. And then I gave you few examples of why and what research question. I hope this lecture is clear. If you have any question regarding this lecture, please write in the comment box below. Thank you very much, and you can stay connected with me on these Facebook and YouTube channels. And if you need any further assistance, you can contact me. Okay? Thank you very much, and have a very nice day.